Matter of fact, before we go in and watch this video, do me a solid. Hit the subscribe button below and the notification bell.
He's still a part of the 12 tribes of Israel.
Right.
That's the point. There's 12 gates. His father got a gate. You understand what I'm saying? And because his father has a gate, what's that mean for him? That means that he has a gate. Why? Because, read what you got.
And they declared their pedigree.
You almost there, but I want you to pay attention to this. Because what's being declared isn't their religion.
Right.
It's their nationality. There's a difference. You understand? So you was, I know what you're saying, but I want you to focus on the nationality part, not the religion piece. You understand what I'm saying? Read.
They declared their pedigrees after their families by the house of their father.
No, by their mother.
Their fathers.
Right. Now, why do I say that? Because it's the same thing with nature, right? If you have a seed, you take an apple seed, and you put this apple seed in that ground right there, what's going to come up? Right. And you take that same seed, and you go put it in Haiti. What's going to come up? Say it again?
Maybe an apple tree.
What type of apple tree?
It might not grow.
Okay, it might not grow. But let's say it does grow. Is it going to be a lemon now?
No, it's still going to be an apple.
It's still going to be an apple. That's the point. So the seed is determined by who? The father. You understand? Not the ground you put it in. Not the womb of the woman. That don't determine your nationality. It might change, you know, how sweet you are, or you understand? It might change the type of fruit it is. You understand what I'm saying? But it's not going to actually make it go from an apple to an orange, or from an apple to a, or from a apple to a lemon. It's not, that's not gonna happen. You following me?
A half apple, half lemon.
You're not gonna get that in the tree. The tree growing apples and lemons at the same time. That's not gonna happen. You following me? So what are we talking about right now? Nationality. So when I said that you were from the tribe of Judah, I was talking about your nationality, right? The point is, these all have one nationality,
right?
And that one nationality is the nation of Israel.
That's right.
You understand? So your nationality is not that you're an American black. Your nationality is that you are an Israelite. That's one nation of all these people. These are all brothers and sisters. You're an Israelite from what tribe? The tribe of Simeon.
Right.
You understand? That's your nationality. Is there a place for you to put that on your job application? No, right? That's why I said that's not the point. The point is that you know that you're not American black. You know that you're not Haitian. You know that you're not Dominican. The point is that you know that you're an Israelite from the tribe of Simeon, right?
Right.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15. How do we know these things? Why? Because you identify with this stuff. I know you identify. If you get Romans chapter 8, if you didn't, you wouldn't have stopped over here. You wouldn't have had these questions. A lot of people come up, they stop, then they leave. A lot of people come up, they stop, then they leave. Why? Because it's safe for them. Your spirit got to bear witness with this stuff. You understand what I'm saying? Read.
Romans 8 and 16. The spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit.
Your spirit bears witness with the spirit of this book, right? Whether you know it or whether you don't. You understand? Whether I know it or whether I don't. Your spirit bears witness with this. If it didn't, you would leave, you would go somewhere. This brother's spirit bear witness with his book. How he been here the whole time, he been asking questions. Good questions, you understand? But his, I don't know if he's going to keep the commandments. I don't.
Chapter 28, verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
The Lord is saying, look, you Israelites, hey, you blacks and Spanish Native Americans.
Don't mind temporarily.
Yeah. Look, the Bible is saying, look, if you're not going to listen to the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, right? All of these curses are going to come upon you. We're going to read it. Come on.
If thou will not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe, to do all his commandments.
If you do not do the commandments, because we read earlier that the commandments are what? The commandments is our religion. You understand? The commandments is our heritage. The commandments is our culture. The commandments is our law. The laws is all of that stuff. That's why when you ask people, what's your religion? Our religion is the laws of the Bible.
Right.
You understand? We've been taught a lot of evil from this man right here.
Right.
A lot of evil right here. Hold on, one question at a time. We've been taught a lot of evil from this man right here.
Bring it
out. You understand? So we have to go into the minds of our people and remove those strongholds.
Right.
Because many of us still believe we African American, we American black, we Haitian, you understand? We Dominican. That's not what we are according to the Bible.
Right.
We gonna prove it and you gonna tell me who we are. Read what you got.
And his statutes, which I command thee, this day.
Come on.
That all these curses.
All these what?
These curses.
All these curses written in the Bible. Come on.
Shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
They're gonna overtake you till you be destroyed. Read verse 32. This is a curse that was written about the children of Israel. Read what you got.
Verse 32.
Come on.
Thy sons and thy daughters
48.
Shall be given unto another people.
One of the curses was that. What would happen? I need you to translate.
Your children be given to another people.
All right, what's that look like?
Slavery.
That looks like slavery, right? All right, who did that happen to?
Blacks.
And who else? Because we're talking about the whole nation.
I'm about to say, yeah.
We're talking about the whole nation. Everybody on the sun, right?
Everybody on there.
Right? All right, and remember, all right, get verse 45. Hold that. Verse 45.
Verse 45.
Come on.
Moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee and shall pursue thee.
All these curses we reading about shall come upon this nation. You understand? This nation right here. Come on. 28.
And 21. Overtake thee.
And what?
And overtake thee.
All these curses was to come upon who and overtake them? Only the nation of Israel. Read what you got.
21.
Yeah, no, 1 and 1.
Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 1. These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
Come on.
On this side Jordan in the wilderness.
So who did Moses speak to? 33 and 4. Who did Moses speak to?
Israel.
Read it again.
These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
Did Moses speak to everybody?
All Israel.
He spoke to Israel. You understand what I'm saying? Only the nation of Israel. He wasn't speaking to the whole world. Right? So those curses we're going to read about only pertain to who? Those blessings we read about only pertain to who? Read what you got.
Deuteronomy 33 verse 4. Moses commanded us a law.
Moses commanded us a law. You understand? The us is Israel. We just read it. Come on.
Even the inheritance of the congregation of Jacob.
Of Jacob. Jacob is Israel. You understand? That's who was given the law. That's who was given the Bible. The curses pertain to the nation of Israel. The blessings pertain to the nation of Israel. Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 45. Read what you got. This is very important because these are signs. Signs of who? The nation of Israel. Well, how do you know? How do you know? How do you know? I know because they tell me. Read what you got.
Deuteronomy 28 verse 45.
Come on.
Moreover, all these curses.
All these what?
Curses.
Come on.
Shall come upon thee and shall pursue thee.
Come on.
And overtake thee till thou be destroyed.
All these curses until you are completely destroyed. Read.
Because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
Now remember, this was told to our forefathers thousands of years ago. Told to our forefathers. This is our history book. This was told to our forefathers, right? Come on.
To keep his commandments.
To do what?
Keep his commandments.
Our forefathers was instructed to keep God's commandments. To keep his laws, right? Come on.
And his statutes.
And what?
And his statutes. Which he commanded thee.
Come on.
And they shall be upon thee for a sign.
The curses, the curses, the curses. Why we got signs out here? So you can see the curses.
Right.
You understand? That's why we got them out here. Come on.
For a sign and for a wonder.
These shall be a sign and a wonder to you today. Thousands of years later, guess what? These curses are still upon you because they came through your blood, through your father. Just like that seed, it's still on you. It ain't changed. You're still the same. Come on.
And upon thy seed forever.
How long?
Forever.
For how long?
Forever.
So these curses will be upon these people for how long? It's forever. So these people stand today, right? Well, how do we know who they are? Because the devil, the deceiver, tells you that he's the nation. That he's Israel, right? He tell you that the white people are Jewish, right? Nah, that's not right. They've taken your culture, destroyed you. You're left with nothing. So now you're cleaving on to everything else that you see around you. But this Bible, the one that most of our people reject, right? Most of us rejected it at one point, but somebody had to wake us up. That's what we're doing. We're waking you up right now. We're telling you the truth according to the Bible.
That's
with
right.
Proof, with evidence. You understand? Line upon line, precept upon precept. That's what we're going to do for you. If you don't like the Bible, then we ain't got much for you. But we can show you you in the Bible. Read.
Because thou servest not the Lord thy God with joyfulness and with gladness of heart.
So what we did, right, was during this time, our forefathers, We weren't happy to keep God's commandments. We weren't happy to deal with a woman and take care of her. You understand? We weren't happy to look out for my brother, to love him as I love myself, right? We wanted to steal from him. You understand? We wanted to come up off of him. You understand? We wanted to lie to him. We wanted to deceive him. You understand? These are all things that our forefathers were struggling with then and that we still struggling with today. It was a lot of black on black crime. There's a lot of babies getting aborted throughout the Bible. You read about all of this stuff in the Bible. Right. The same things happening today.
Right.
That's why the same people today is cursed.
Bring it up.
So that you can know. That's why we had these signs, so you can see it. Make it plain. Right down the street, Planned Parenthood. You understand? What's inside of it? Black Lives Matter. Who are they supporting? Homosexuals. You understand? That's not according to the Bible. The Bible tells you don't be a homosexual. The Bible tells you to not lay down with animals. You understand? Right. Some people that do those things, right? The Bible tells us to not have orgies and threesomes. You understand? But we've learned those things from who? From other nations around us, right? For our destruction. All these things are our destruction. And now today, right, we are cursed in the city. Today. That's where we at right now, the ghetto. You look ghetto up on your phone, it's going to tell you a place where the Jews reside.
Right.
Who lives in the ghetto today? Do these people live in the ghetto? No. Your brothers and sisters live in the ghetto.
Right.
The Israelites live in the ghetto.
Right.
You understand? Why? Because it's prophecy.
Right.
The curses are still on you today.
That's right.
Read.
Because thou servest not the Lord thy God.
Verse 48. Come on.
Therefore shalt thou serve thy enemies.
Thou shalt do what?
Serve thy enemies.
So one of the curses would be that we do what?
Serve thy enemies.
That you would serve your enemies.
Right.
Not your friends. You understand? Your enemies. The people you hate. The people that rule over you. Get 26 and 17 Leviticus. You're going to serve these people. Why? Why? Because you curse for what? For not doing what?
No, it ain't not.
We read it earlier.
No, what you said earlier was,
verse 15.
If the seed is contaminated, right, and the seed is planted, if your father didn't, do something right, the curse is placed upon your father and his seed. So you suffering something you didn't even do then. That's
yes,
what you're
yes, yes.
And you can't make it right because you're cursed forever.
I'm gonna make
your father did the wrong thing.
Correct, correct.
So it's over with, it's forever.
You can make it right, right? You can make it right. Officer Host, look up Deuteronomy, I think it's 24 or 25. Where it talks about one man shall be put to death for his own sin or something like that. We're gonna read that for you because it's not over for us, right? Our fathers have done things to set us behind. So we behind right now, right? We behind. There's hope for us. It's always hope for the nation of Israel because we have the Most High God on our side.
Right.
It's always hope for us.
24 and 16.
All right, hold that. I want to get that next. Read what I told you to read first. Read what you got.
Deuteronomy 28 and verse 13.
Come on.
But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God,
come on,
to observe, to do all his commandments,
come on,
and his statutes, which I command thee this day,
come on,
that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So our forefathers didn't keep the commandments, so they were cursed. You understand? Then they had children, right? If you're not keeping the commandments, what's the chances of your children? Exactly. If they're not keeping the commandments, what's the chances of their children? Exactly. But don't the children have a choice? Don't they have a choice? They do. You understand? And that's the same choice we have today. Deuteronomy chapter 24. Read.
Deuteronomy 24 and verse 16.
Come on.
The fathers shall not be put to death for the children.
Come on.
Neither shall the children.
Neither shall who?
The children be put to death for the fathers.
Right. It's always hope for the nation because you can make your own decisions. You understand? You have a chance to fix the line. You got a chance to save your father, believe it or not. All right?
That was Moses that said that.
Yeah, that was that. What? That said what?
Went in and said whatever they said to the fathers on this day.
That was the same person, Moses.
All right, Moses, right?
Yes.
All right,
yes,
Moses did that. What was the point of placing the curse upon them forever if it was the point of y'all to be able to go make it right?
Repentance. Repentance. You understand? Repentance. That's the point. I'm going, do you have any children?
But why curse the children from the beginning if you won't forgive them?
Do you have children?
Yeah.
You have children?
I have two children.
All right, all praises. You going to understand this point then. All right? Because there's different levels of understanding that come with life. And you have children, right?
Yeah.
All right. So from what you just said, my assumption is that you've never disciplined your children.
Not discipline my children.
You hold on. Why you do that? Why you discipline your children?
What do you mean why discipline?
Why? Why you discipline?
Right or wrong?
Why do they need to know that?
Making plays.
Why didn't he know the difference between right and wrong?
Without order is chaos.
Say it again.
Without order is chaos.
All right, so the same mindset order. That you have about your children is the same mindset that the Lord has about his.
That's right.
These are his children.
Right.
Get Exodus chapter 4, verse 22. These are his children. Not only that, but his firstborn. You got a son? All right, he your firstborn? That is right there. So you know the level of care that you have for your firstborn. You understand? For all your sons, your children, your daughters too. Right? You just not going to discipline them? Well, that's the answer to your question. The Lord disciplined his children, right? So that it would be well for them in the end. He cares for their end. Right? So we had to go through this butt whipping right here that you see on these sons. We had to go through that so that today we can repent. Today we can come up out of this. Today, hold on, I'm gonna answer your question. You understand? Today we can get our spirits right in hopes to get the kingdom because the world ain't over yet. It's gonna be over soon.
The ones who have repented and all this stuff still getting their ass whooped.
Those who have repented.
They still follow the system of America, so.
We are still suffering, and that's why the hope is for Christ, right? We need a savior. Martin Luther King, name some black revolutionaries for me. Read what you got.
It's the world, Luke.
Yeah, it's the world. You can't
think about it. Think about it. I want y'all to think about it.
My brother.
I know you know some. Name some black revolutionaries for me.
No, it ain't about naming the world. Hey, may I say something?
Hold on.
And then dip.
No, you can't. I'm talking right now. All right? The scripture says, don't interrupt a man to miss his speech. You got to deal things decently and in order, all right? If you stay here, I will ask you your question and then I will listen to you and we'll have a dialogue. But I can't just let you come in and disrupt what we got going on. That would be out of order. You understand what I'm saying?
I got you.
All right.
My brother, have a blessed day.
All right. Yep.
And
all right.
And
hold on, we're gonna read the scripture. Read what you got.
Right.
What you want?
Deuteronomy 28.
Okay, got you.
Yeah, read that.
15?
No, 48.
Got you.
Read.
Therefore shalt thou serve thy enemies, which the Lord shall send against thee, in hunger, and in thirst, and in nakedness, and in the want of all things.
So there's nothing really that we don't rely on our enemies for today. Today, you understand? Now, there's other nations of people, like the Arabs, you understand, that rely on themselves. The Chinese, you got Chinatowns, they rely on themselves. The so-called white man, his nation, they rely on themselves, you understand?
Really?
Say it again?
Do they really?
Well,
they rely on themselves.
They rely on, when I say that, I mean they have enough substance to deal with their own, or they can use you to do it for free. You understand?
They,
like, yeah, we built America, no question, but were we in power doing that, or were they in power? They were, you understand? So. You know, they were trading us as slaves and merchandise to Spain, trading us as trading merchandise to the Dutch and to the French. You understand? All of those are who? These people right here, right? So we depend upon them. We're at their mercy for everything. Everything we need, we at that their mercy for that, right? What you got? What you got? Deuteronomy? Exodus? Yeah, get Exodus. Exodus 4. Because I want to show you that the Lord deals with his children just like you deal with yours. Just like you deal with yours. It's just to another level because he's dealing with a nation of wicked people. Right? You're dealing with a few sons, a few daughters. It's totally different. Right? Totally different. And this is a God of all eternity. You understand? You are the Lord of your household for what, 70 years maybe? Something like that. And then what? You're going back to the earth. Same thing you was created from. The Most High God created you for that, to go through that process. That's in the Bible too. Read.
Exodus chapter 4, verse 22.
Come on.
And thou shalt say unto Pharaoh,
come on.
Thus saith the Lord, Israel is my son, even my firstborn.
You see that? The Lord looks at this nation. It's 18 nations, right, upon the whole earth. The Lord looks at this one and says, this is mine. This is mine. All the other ones, right, get that address. All the other ones, I ain't really dealing with like that. You understand? They just here as supporting cast. You the main character. It's a movie going on right now, and Israel's the main character. Everybody else got a role to play, right? But they're not the main character, right? The kingdom is for the main character.
Right.
The kingdom is for the nation of Israel. You understand what I'm saying? That's how it always has been, and that's how it always will be. Read what you got.
2 Ezra chapter 6 and verse 58.
Come on.
But we, thy people, whom thou hast called thy firstborn, the only begotten, and the fervent lover are given into their hands. If the world now be made for our sakes, why do we not possess an inheritance?
Right, so get to the point. I think it's verse 58, 57, 55. Get 55. This is the point right here. Because we're talking about who? The nation of Israel. They're the people that were set on high, right? The nation that God chose. But what about everybody else? Read what you got.
Verse 55. All these have I spoken before thee. Oh, Lord.
Read verse 56.
Verse 56. As for the other people.
As for the other people, right? Come on.
Which also come of Adam.
Because everybody on the earth comes from Adam, right? Come on.
Thou I said, they are nothing.
They are what?
They are nothing.
What did God say?
They are nothing. But be like unto spittle.
Like unto what?
Spittle. And as liken thee, the abundance of them unto a drop that falleth from a vessel.
So they like one drop you lose from a whole bucket of water. You know how you're trying to take a water from here across the street? It might shake a little bit, a drop might fall out. That's how the Lord look at them. Just one drop from that bucket, you understand? So this is God level, right? The name Israel means what? Princes of the power with God.
Right.
That's what the name Israel means. So the true God bodies on this earth are the Israelites who have repented.
Right.
The Israelites who are keeping God's commandments.
Right.
You're looking at some right here. It's some all throughout the earth. This ain't it. You understand? People waking up all over the place, right? This world is coming to an end.
That's right.
It's dying right before you. Right before you. Pestilences, people walking around with masks. This ain't gonna get better. It's not going to get better. After this is done, something else is coming. And then something else is coming until Christ comes to redeem his people. I want you to get it. Luke chapter 1. Why are we reading this? Because this is your history. These are the things that you need to know. Right? And I want you to go back to Deuteronomy. Right? And get verse 68. Read what you got.
Luke chapter 1 verse 68.
Come on.
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel.
Come on.
For he hath visited and redeemed his people.
So you say, well, it's so much curses, so many things that happen to us. What are we going to do? You know? Is it a chance for us? Yeah, it's a chance because a child can make his own decision. You can make your own decision. You ain't got to follow in the ways of your forefathers. You can change that and set your children up for success as they come, right? But to get up out of this ghetto that we in, the bottom of society all throughout the world, don't matter where you go. We in America right now, but you go to Africa is the same way. You go to Europe is the same way. You go to London. You go to Jamaica. In any part of the earth, who's on the bottom? These people you see right here. You understand? That's the sign. Come on.
And hath raised up an horn of salvation for us in the house of his servant David.
Come on. That's Christ we're talking about. The horn of salvation for David, that's Christ we're talking about. Come on.
As he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets.
Because the prophets prophesied that Christ would come back and deliver the nation from their enemies. That's the whole purpose of Christ, was to save the nation of Israel from all the enemies that the nation of Israel has. That's Christ's purpose. It's not to come back and save the whole wide world.
Right.
That's a lie that was taught by this man right here. You understand? And all the doctrines, you understand, that's associated with him. All of the Baptists, the Pentecostal, make it plain for you. The Seventh-day Adventists, what else you got? Egyptology, Mormonism, all those religions, all those things that you, in your mind, when you think about them today, you would associate them with religions, right? The reason why you have that thought is because of your oppressor. God don't deal with religions. He deal with a culture for one people. That one people is the nation of Israel.
Right.
That's all he deal with. That's it. You're going to keep my commandments or you're not going to keep them. What's up? Right? I'm going to give you blessings for keeping them. I'm going to give you curses for not. What's up? You understand? Oh, you destroy it? All right. If you get your act together and repent. You understand? Get your act together and repent. Stop doing what's evil. Learn what's good and do it. Then I'll send my son back to save you from who?
As he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets, which have been since the world began, that we should be saved from our enemies.
That we should what?
Be saved from our enemies.
That we should be saved from our enemies. You understand? We need a savior. Everybody you see don't need a savior. What they need to be saved from? You tell me. What these people need to be saved from? They in rulership. They rule the whole world.
Right.
What you need to be saved from? The whole world is being ruled by America right now. And its counterparts, allies. Yeah. Right? We ain't got no representation inside of that system.
Right.
What seat do we have in the what is it in the United Nations? What seat do we have? We don't have one because we the bread and butter. You understand? They have that because of our destruction. They've replaced us. They're ruling the earth, but we're supposed to be ruling the earth. You understand? And we're not gonna be able to overcome them by might and by our own power. We need the power of the Lord Jesus the Christ. That's the only way.
right? Christ gonna come back. He gonna redeem us out of this place. He gonna take us somewhere else. But he's only gonna redeem those that have repented and are keeping God's commandments.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.